Hello! In this tutorial, we will learn about the new Scriptcase responsive menu launched in version 9.10. In version 9.10 of Scriptcase, the menu has been completely remodeled. We recreated the application to bring a fluid and responsive experience to the menus generated by Scriptcase. So let's get to know the new options. We now have available to us different types of menu possibilities that were added to the menu. Vertical with the separate tube, vertical without the tube, horizontal with items inside the menu, as well as menu within menu and other possibilities that you can now create with the new Scriptcase menu. Right clicking on the new menu, we can inspect it and see that the new menu is completely fluid with its new redesigned system and layout. We have a completely fluid and fully mobile and tablet functional menu. Checking the menu further on mobile devices, we can see that the new 9.10 menu is fully mobile compatible and works really fluidly. With this new menu, you will also be able to design now fully mobile and tablet responsive systems, all created within Scriptcase. So let's go ahead and create a new menu application and check out how we can create a menu like this, or like maybe one of the others that we have seen. Now, the old menu system is still available within the new application creation interface, and you can just select that and create that, or the tree menu if you prefer so. Otherwise, the new menu system will be found up here to the right with its own icon and also with the currently new indication. Clicking the menu, we can then start to create a new menu interface for our Scriptcase applications. Now, if you are already familiar with the Scriptcase interface, then you will feel right at home. Just continue, click create, and you will see a new interface for this new menu system where we can go ahead and start to create or insert new items. So I'll start by adding our first item, which I will call customers. I can include a description here, which is then also included within the vertical menu system. I can also include links here, and for links, we would then link that to an application. We can then either insert the name of an application we want to link that to, or we can click there the link icon and choose the application we want to import and create that linkage. We also then have the option to set the target application. We can leave this blank or specify otherwise. Creating a shortcut allows us to place this menu item into the toolbar menu items shortcuts section. We will come to that in a few moments. So for now, I will set this as a shortcut. At the bottom here, we have then also the option to display text and image, or only text. So if I uncheck that, the icon field will become unavailable, and checking it, the icon will become visible within the menu, as well as available for us to select within the Font Awesome library. So now with an icon set, I can go ahead and add the next item, and here I will call that, say, categories. Like so, and I will add two more, and I will call this one add customer, and the next one I will also call then add category. And I will give both of these the plus icon. And just like that, we've added icons to both of the menu items. And now we can go ahead and adjust them to into the position where we want them, below, beside, or However, now do note, if you want to have a higher key, then the top of the higher key will only open or expand the menu items and will not have the link application as an option right now. Now, this may be an option in the future, but right now, this is how you would go ahead and create your links. So in that case, I could add customers below here, add categories there, and we can go ahead and add two more items into the menu. Like so. As an example, we would create that like so. Now these grid applications don't exist. And we could add our application names in there. And just like that, that would then be functional as a menu. And then if we go ahead and run the menu, we can now see that we have here our menu items. We have also a search available that will search our available menu items here. So here I could start entering customers, for instance, and then it will open the search application on those selected applications. So on the search list, that would be a grid application where the search module is available and functional, and that would then open the search for the user. You have then also theme options available, as well as the user profile, which is then also completed with the profile user when generated, which is then also filled in with the user profile image once logged in with the security. Otherwise, this default image is generated. Returning back to the menu, we can add further items here, or we can go ahead and define some more of these here as shortcuts. So I have here now our add categories, add customer as shortcuts. I will remove then here the add customers. In fact, save that. And then we can go ahead and run our application again. And those are now also added here as shortcuts for our application. Within the user menu, we can customize the user menu objects, which are available here within the profile user menu. Here we can add a user image, the username, as well as a description. Or we can add our own variables or comments within the description content. Below that, we can also add menu items, which we can then make accessible to the end user. So here, for instance, we can add settings, change password, add the FAQ here also, and then the option to log out. And then we can add our icons in there. And of course, link those also to our applications. And they will then also be available within the user profile menu. For the user menu, we have the same options as we have also for the menu items. The option to add a description, link the application, provide the target application, set text and image, and then also specifying the icon or image, in this case, for the menu item. Within the toolbar items tab, we can enable the search functionality within the menu. We can also choose to display the item path on search. We can also enable or disable portal platform languages. So any languages that you add to your project within the Scriptcase environment would then also be available to the end user by checking this box. We can also enable and disable themes, as well as choose the themes we want to make available to the end user. For shortcuts, we can readjust or position them differently and also enable or disable them entirely from the user menu. Then if we go ahead and run again, we can then see that we have made some slight modifications to the menu, but of course we have left some of those options available to the end user. Now we can also go ahead and change the menu positioning and the layout of this menu by checking the menu tab. Within the menu tab, we can change the orientation of the menu from horizontal to vertical. And there we then have our vertical menu layout, which is again fully mobile, responsive in design and functionality. We have then also all the same features available as we had previously, and we can also choose to position them differently again within the layout tab options. We can enable or disable the toolbar entirely. We can add logos in here and display those then within our application. We can also change the theme that is available for the menu in the first place. And of course, add here, for instance, any header text, such as your company name. And we can also change the position of the header text, say from the main menu to the header, or from the header to the main menu. And just like that, we have made specific adjustments and changes to our new menu system. And we can, of course, go back into Scriptcase and change the position of any of those when we feel that we want them in a different position. It works super fluid and is super functional, providing you with all the features you need for menu creation. So let's go ahead and add some applications to these links so that we can see what we are actually looking at. So we have here the grid comparison available. So I will go ahead and add that into each of these. And then we can see really what it would look like with the tabs enabled as well as without tabs enabled and so forth. So if I open then an application, I can then go ahead and open further applications within tabs within this nice new menu. And we see it is really nice and functional. And let's go ahead and check that also on mobile devices. And here we have then our new menu system, which is working beautifully on mobile devices, as well as then our applications and grids, forms, and so forth. Now the new 9.10 version of Scriptcase includes this new menu system that you can now include within your own projects developed in Scriptcase. It's super functional, very easy to use, and of course, very easy to adjust. Further options and features will be added to this menu as over the coming months. New theming options and more will be added also. Now, if you want to go ahead and import your old menu, you can do so by choosing here in the menu option, Import Menu, and then choose the old menu from which you want to import all of the menu items. Those menu items would then also be imported into your current menu and then added in here. Any events will also be imported into the new menu system, but it is important to note that this new menu system does not include images, so images will not be imported with the old menu. That is because the new menu system has Font Awesome icons included throughout, and this is for fully fluid and responsive applications, enabling you to create faster and better systems. Now, I hope you like the new menu system that is now included within version 9.10 of Scriptcase. Thank you very much for watching, and until the next time.